Hi everybody, my name is Grace Kelly. I am a saxophonist, singer, composer, musician, and a little bit about me. I started playing the saxophone when I was 10 years old, started performing professionally since the age of 12, and at this point, tallying up that I have played over 800 concerts in about 30 countries, headlining festivals with my band, the Grace Kelly Quartet, from everywhere from the Montreal Jazz Fest to the Newport Jazz Festival, Madagascar, Oslo Jazz Fest, and working with some of my favorite musicians in the whole wide world. I've been really blessed to be mentored by some of my favorite alto saxophonists, including Lee Konitz, Phil Woods, Frank Morgan. I actually did two separate recordings, albums, with both Lee Konitz and Phil Woods. And the late, great Phil Woods and I actually toured together. We did a 6-week tour once, all in Europe. We played the Playboy Jazz Fest at the Hollywood Bowl. We played everywhere. And my most the latest venture of mine has been, I've been playing in the house band for The Late Show with Stephen Colbert under the direction of great pianist singer from New Orleans, Jean Baptiste. And then most currently doing a lot of touring with my own band. I also love doing a lot of teaching stuff. I'm developing a lot of online video materials about the way I approach this wonderful, fascinating, and at times frustrating, but exciting instrument. And I love to travel all around and do workshops and talk about improvisation for not only advanced players, but I really love talking to advanced beginners and intermediate. And the thing that I love the most about teaching and about just, you know, bringing knowledge and things that I've thought about is to see that light bulb moment for students and for other players. So whether it's a light bulb moment about improvisation or, you know, you try a new amazing Van Doren mouthpiece and that completely changes the way you play, because believe me, that absolutely happens down to the ligature and reed and mouthpiece. But that's kind of been my latest journey. I've released 10 albums now with my band. My first recording was when I was 12. And living in New York City and just staying really busy, touring, you know, living the dream and continuing to grow and find new avenues with this instrument. I've always been on a search to find the best equipment that lets me play with the most ease. Because when I'm on stage, when I'm practicing, I really don't want to think about anything other than what's in here and getting it out. So I'm playing the A8 mouthpiece. This is the new one. It's an S plus chamber. I was on the A8 small chamber for a while, but then when the plus came out, I was with David Gould and I tried and it was even more open and just gave more projection and warmth. And I've been playing Java green box reeds for a while now. I play a 2.5 and I like it because I can rip the reed open, put it on and it plays. I don't really have any patience for breaking reeds in. I wish I did, but I just love how they speak. And I've tried, you know, the red box and blue box, but the green box works for me and it also coordinates. No, I'm just kidding. I don't pick it because of my hair color. And then the leather ligature, which I love. I've always been attracted to a darker tone and sound. And so I think Steve Wilson was the first one who hit me to the Van Doren leather ligature. So I highly recommend that. I've been with Van Doren now for probably almost 8 to 10 years, actually. Crazy to think. I remember first talking with them when I was with my mentor, Lee Konitz, and was out with David. And, you know, that's when I had already been playing Van Doren, and I was really delighted to then completely be on board and be part of the family. I have this fun exercise that I like to teach to my students, which is basically like taking the idea of transcription, because a lot of students ask me, how do I use transcription to get better? You know, and it's one thing to just write it down or to read it and forget it tomorrow. But what I like to do is take just a little chunk of something you've transcribed. It could literally be a bar. So I'd like to take that phrase and transpose it to all the keys. Here's an example. Do that in all the keys, get really familiar with it, and then I would put on, you know, a recording of a song that I was working on, and I would try to play that line within it, like, way overplay it, because this is an exercise. And then what I would start to do is I'd start to play with the line and make it a little bit more my own. So I would do something where I would just add different rhythms to it. And then maybe start to add a few other notes to it. And then I would start to like really get creative and use the shape of the line. So this line is going up in a major seven arpeggio. So say just take that line, but now change your notes. So playing all lines, da 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 da, seven notes, but just changing the shapes. And so this is a way that by starting very literally, you can practice in all keys, you can play it very literally, but then you want to make it your own so that when you're on stage and you're playing, all of a sudden it comes out in a very organic way. And a line that started as a transcription now 100% becomes your own thing. So you could try it out and use that for transcription. You're going to come up with some very, very cool stuff. Thank you.